Hello children, in the previous sessions of physics class, we all studied what is motion, what are different types of motions, what is velocity, what are uniform and non-uniform motion of a body, and we also learned the formulas on velocity and to find average velocity also, and we solved few example problems also. So let us continue with the lesson, and today we should study about what is acceleration. Now we all know what is velocity, rate of change of speed or speed of a body with respect to time. Whenever we use the word rate, it means it is with respect to time itself. Of course, if the speed is changing with time, then it is velocity. If at all the velocity itself, the distance is changing with time, then it is speed or velocity. If at all the velocity itself is changing with time, then what is it called? It is called the acceleration. So, acceleration is defined as the rate of change of velocity. Velocity. I am telling you again, the word rate here means with respect to time it is changing. So rate of change of velocity of a body is called acceleration. If you write it in the form of formula, then acceleration is change in velocity divided by time taken. Change in velocity divided by time taken gives you acceleration. If you write it in terms of the alphabets, then how do we represent acceleration? Means it is represented by small letter A. You cannot use capital letter A. Small letter A is used for acceleration. You have learned all this in 8th standard textbook. So acceleration is represented by small letter A, which is equal to u into v divided by v. Velocity means just v. You know, velocity is v divided by time taken is v. Why this u? You may question. Yes, no? Why? Because it is not just the velocity, but this change in velocity. We all know about the initial and the final velocity of the body. Yes, so initial velocity means with what speed it is starting. As soon as you start the vehicle, you cannot start with fourth gear order of the car. Yes, so if you want to, you cannot accelerate it directly. You have to first start slowly and then go on increasing the speed. So with what speed you are starting the motion or starting to move, the initial velocity, and next with what velocity you travel is the final velocity, and again you come to end. You will stop the vehicle or stop the rate, but what action of motion, that is, it comes to end. So here change in velocity. So when you start the car, suppose you are driving the car, when you start the car, your velocity is different. When you are moving with some speed, your velocity again changes. If at all you are stopped by the signal, again you will come to rest. Again, when the green signal goes, again you will start moving, again you will change the velocity. Like this, the velocity will keep on changing with respect to time, and it is called acceleration. And acceleration is change in velocity by time. So we have habit of writing what habit, how do we represent this initial velocity? Initial velocity is represented by u, and final velocity V in the equations of motion which you have studied. So u is the initial velocity, v is the final velocity. If I want to find out how, what is the change of velocity, then v minus u I do, means final velocity minus initial velocity, when I do, I can find out with what acceleration it is, what is its speed. So change in velocity means simply we cannot write v, I am writing its initial velocity u as well. So u, divided by t is the acceleration. SI is the SI unit. So the SI unit is very important, children. So unit of velocity is meter per second. So acceleration is velocity by time. Here I will show you how we unit. Acceleration is velocity by time, we came to know. So let us write the units. If at all you forget the unit in test or exam, children, this is the logic of you. Acceleration is velocity by time. For velocity also we find it out like the direction of bullet is in one direction, whereas the recoil of the gun is in the opposite direction. So that is the example. Both are in different directions. So that is the example. So if velocity is in the same direction, the acceleration is in the direction of velocity, acceleration is positive. If acceleration is, sorry, the motion of the body is opposite to the direction of velocity, then acceleration is taken as negative. So as we have studied what are uniform and non-uniform motion, in case of acceleration also, children, you have uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. What is uniform acceleration? You know what is uniform velocity? If the object is coming equal distances in equal interval of time, then it is called uniform velocity. If the object is coming unequal distances in unequal intervals of time, then it is called non-uniform velocity. Similarly, uniform acceleration.